Now, I've been reading your comments lately, and I could tell you guys are sick and tired. And I'm not trying to scare anyone, but maybe you guys should go see the doctor. In case you haven't heard, there's something called the coronavirus spreading all over the world, and even claiming lives. Now, if you've been following our channel, you know all about the coronavirus, how dangerous it really is, and you most likely know that we still don't fully understand what we're dealing with here. Which begs the question, what if the coronavirus wiped out half the population? How's it going, guys? Welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions. I'm your host, Jared Bronstein, and today we're talking about the coronavirus. Make sure to subscribe and click the bell icon to never miss a video, and give this one a thumbs up if you enjoy it. I'll be replying to some comments to wrap this one up, but for now, let's get right into it. So if you've seen some of our other videos recently, I'm sure you've heard all of this before. But for those of you who haven't, let's first talk about what the virus is. Contrary to popular belief, coronavirus, COV, is simply a term to describe a family of viruses that could cause us to feel sick. From the common cold to much more severe diseases, this specific coronavirus is currently being referred to as the 2019 novel coronavirus, or 2019 nCoV. Symptoms of the virus include headache, runny nose, cough, sore throat, fever, and just overall feeling ill. The virus can lead to pneumonia, but only in the most severe cases. For the most part, if you do get the coronavirus, you just need to wait for your body to fight off the infection, as there is no cure for it. Those most at risk include infants, elderly, or anyone already dealing with an illness. Due to the fact their immune systems are weaker than, say, the average 25-year-old, they're much more susceptible to contracting a more deadly virus. As of this recording, the virus seems to be going international, with cases being confirmed in continents all over the world. Countries with confirmed cases include Canada, the United States, China, Thailand, Japan, Australia, France, Germany, South Korea, Cambodia, Finland, United Arab Emirates, and a handful of others. As of now, it seems Africa, South America, and Antarctica are the only continents that do not have any confirmed cases. So hypothetically, let's say this virus wipes out half of our population. Not to say our remaining survivors would all have been infected at one point or another. Maybe some were able to beat the virus, and others were fortunate enough to never have been infected at all. Where do we go from here? Well, first things first, it wouldn't be an even divide of people from every country all over the world dying. Considering how the virus started in China, has already infected over 6,000 people in China, killing 133 of them, I think it would be logical to say a lot of those who did in fact get wiped out were either Chinese locals or were living in China when the outbreak first happened. But we're not going to say the entire 1.4 billion population of China died because of this virus. In fact, 126 of those infected have already recovered. But it seems if half the world's population was wiped out due to the virus, I would say at least a few million, or even 100 million, would be from China, simply due to the fact that it not only started there, but that's where it's spreading the quickest. It seems the virus would eventually go worldwide, killing people in every country. But again, we need to consider things like resources, such as facilities and personnel. Odds are someone with coronavirus is more likely to survive a bad case if they were to contract the virus in a developed country, compared to someone who would contract it in a developing country. But on the flip side, as previously mentioned, Africa, Antarctica, and South America are the only continents without any confirmed cases of the virus. It is very possible they quarantine themselves from the rest of the world, setting up barricades and banning anyone from entering their respective countries. I mean, I'm not sure how many people are living in Antarctica, but Africa's population of approximately 1.26 billion and South America's population of 422 million would make up at least a quarter of the world's population. Regardless of how you decide which countries get affected and why, one thing is for sure, the world's population would go from approximately 7.8 billion to just under 4 billion. And with such a drop in population, well, surely things would change worldwide. We'd have plenty more resources and there wouldn't be nearly as much pollution. Aside from this, odds are those who died from the virus were mostly children or elderly, or someone already ill, which means the world's average age would most likely be a young adult, anywhere between 25 and 40, and mostly healthy. But at the end of the day, none of this really matters, because if the coronavirus did wipe out half the population, who's to say it wouldn't eventually kill the rest of us? Even those who were able to beat the virus the first time around may not be as fortunate should they contract it again. This leads me to believe the entire world's focus would be finding a cure or a vaccine for the virus responsible for killing close to 4 billion people. Countries would pool their resources together and most likely put their differences aside. At the end of the day, saving the human race would be much more important than fighting over land or arguing about fair trade deals. The idea of repopulating wouldn't even be much of a thought at first, due to the fact that we'd be worried about saving our own lives. Eventually, I do believe we'd be able to find a cure, and rather quickly. Putting the world's best together, giving them unlimited resources and money, as well as support, there's no reason why we wouldn't be able to accomplish this. Eventually, the population would start to grow again, as it does every day. In a sense, over time, we may even see this tragic loss as a blessing in disguise. The population being slashed in half would be such a benefit for the world and its natural resources that things like climate change and carbon footprints probably wouldn't be that big of a deal either. Now, with that being said, I'm not saying that cutting the world's population in half is what we need to do. No, we just need to find ways to be more sustainable so we can continue living on Earth and not destroy it to the point that it's inhabitable. In regards to those affected by the coronavirus, I certainly hope they recover as soon as possible and that we can find a cure, or at least find a way to stop this virus from spreading and claiming more lives. Now, before we do some comment replies, drop some comments below with your thoughts on this one. How would you feel if the virus wiped out an entire country or even half the world's population? Let me know below. For now, let's reply to some comments from the video. What if the coronavirus can't be contained? Food said, yet again, I will blame this channel for jinxing it if this actually happened. What was the first thing that we jinxed that actually happened? I'm curious. Like, did something that we predict happen and then we're to blame? Please let me know. Green Knight Rivers said, time to move to Mars. I'll be honest, when I was scripting this video, I was gonna reference Elon Musk, the whole Mars thing, which I also do quite frequently, but I chose not to. But another thing is, if it wiped out half the population, just jump on a plane with Elon and go to Mars. Jacob said, I have the coronavirus. I'm sorry to hear, Jacob. I hope you recover quickly and stay home and don't come into contact with anybody and wash your hands on a regular basis, and hopefully you'll kick it. Anyways, guys, gonna wrap this one up. I've been your host, Jared Bronstein. You guys have been watching Life's Biggest Questions. Let us know in the comments down below some other questions you may have for us and like us to answer. Make sure to subscribe and give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Share it with a friend, and we'll see you in the next one.